Ready?
I guess. But isn't your mom gonna freak?
She's probably cooking with the radio on. She won't hear a thing.
I bet she'll notice a hole in the floor.
Trust in science, Max. Even when science means blowing shit up.
Tell me that wasn't the coolest thing you've ever seen!
That was truly amazing. Why are explosions so awesome?
That's like asking, why are puppies cute? Some things just are.
I'm not sure your mom would see it that way.
When she asked me to get rid of my old junk, she never specified how. But I guess I better do some actual cleaning too. I'll be excavating the closet. If you see anything else to trash, help a girl out and chuck it on the pile over there.
It feels like I've spent half my life hanging out in this room. Probably because I have. I can't believe those days are all over. Chloe with her cleaning. And while I'm at it, I can take one long last look around this place. As usual, Chloe's grades are better than mine. I still kick her butt in PE though. That was awesome. Who else but Chloe could turn cleaning her room into a pyrotechnical adventure? People say a lot of things about the Prescott family, but this is pretty cool. I was lucky to survive Chloe's magic phase with all my fingers intact.
This seems like a good candidate.
Are you insane? That's my entire magic collection. Do you know how many weeks of allowance this cost?
You haven't touched these since the fifth grade talent show.
Maybe because my assistant turned out to be squeamish at the sight of fake blood.
At least you didn't saw me in half. How are you planning to clean this place if you won't throw away anything?
A magician never reveals her secrets. Put it back.
I bet Chloe's parents were freaking out when she got this letter. I still can't believe you're a Blackwell Academy student. How is it,
Oh, the classes are incredible. The teachers are actually smart. And the lab is legit. Petri dishes for days.
What about the students? Are they as stuck up as you thought they'd be?
They're fine.
Chloe, you're terrible at hiding your feelings. Is everything okay?
I don't know, I like hanging out with normal people. Like you.
Thanks. I guess.
You know what I mean. I hate fake people. You're real.
Thanks. Hey, what's your dad's camera doing in here?
Dad said I could bring it up here for you to use. He's tired of watching you drool all over yourself every time he uses it. His words.
Your dad is the best.
Sure. Just don't ever tell him that. We need to keep him on his toes. You're off to a great start.
Actually, it's kind of cool. I think Chloe used to call this guy Mr. Sharky. I doubt she plays with it anymore.
You better not be thinking what I think you are.
Chloe, I haven't seen you touch this guy in years. Why do you care?
Why do I care? If you throw my beloved childhood friend into the trash? I don't think that deserves an answer.
Sorry, chum.
That's better.
Chloe's been beating me for a while, but that growth spurt could come any day now. We bought this as a gag years ago. I honestly can't believe Chloe still has it. What about this half-eaten jawbreaker? A serious biohazard.
You promised me we'd finish it together no matter how long it took. Don't be a quitter.
You're right.
Yes! The never-ending candy lives on.
Okay, whenever I'm ready, I can go tell Chloe I'm done arguing about trash with her. Let this box of trash be a sacrifice to you, O almighty Chloe Bear. This was our first unsupervised concert together. It was so much fun. We were supposed to see another show next month, but...
How sick was that show?
The sickest.
I've been working on my moves for the next one. Check it out. How about you? Any new moves?
Yeah, totally. I've been working on my air guitar.
Damn, Caulfield. Save something for when it counts. All right, back to the junk mines.
Chloe and I haven't played this game in forever. And I'm pretty sure it's missing pieces.
What are you doing?
Adding this to the pile.
No freaking way. Just because I beat your ass every time we play doesn't make it trash.
That's BS. The last time we played, I wiped the floor with you.
Poor Max. Losing your memory at such a young age. Guess we'll have to play again soon and find out.
Chloe's always preferred imaginary animals to real ones. Well, besides Bongo, of course. Chloe's mom wanted us to go through this pile of old clothes and find stuff to donate. Instead, we played dress up for an hour. Chloe's had this hung up on her wall forever, but neither of us can figure out what happened to the last panel. I hope Dr. Kloenstein's okay. That was awesome. Who else but Chloe could turn cleaning her room into a pyrotechnical adventure? Chloe's had this hoodie for years. It's her favorite. I don't think she'd mean to throw it away. Chloe keeps trying to get me to hop on her board. I'd rather take pictures. Chloe's such a nerd. She hangs on to all her old textbooks and school supplies. Whoa. Talk about embarrassing. How about these boy band trading cards? Super cringeworthy.
Yeah, and hilarious. Remember when we gave them all makeovers?
You mean when you drew boobs on all of them? I was so mad at you.
And yet, our friendship lived on. So too will these cards.
Live fast, die young, and go out with a bang. Rest in pieces, doll. Mm-hmm. It's so hard to believe. This room, this house, this town, all in the past now, or soon to be. Who even am I without Chloe? She's the one who's always starting things, pulling us into adventures. I can't imagine life without her. Maybe I haven't told her I'm leaving yet because I still can't believe it's real myself. That's it. I'm calling off the search. If
you want more trash, you'll have to find it yourself.
Well, it wasn't exactly the purge Mom was hoping for, but at least we tried, right?
Right.
And now we've got the whole day ahead of us. What do two undersupervised friends with clean rooms and clean slates want to get into today?
I guess now would be a good time to tell Chloe I'm leaving. Or I could let us enjoy the day first and tell her later. Actually, Chloe, I really have to tell you something. I don't know how
to... Shit! Max, hold that thought. This must have fallen out when I was digging around in here. Do you have any idea what this is?
Whatever it is, it looks like it came out of our pirate phase.
Your powers of deduction are as strong as ever. This tape is from 5 years ago. It's a message from our past selves to our current selves.
So we were 8 years old? That's crazy. I can't even imagine what we sounded like.
Ready to find out?
Uncovered the audio log of the most fearsome pirates in the bays of Arcadia. Captain Bluebeard and Long Mac Silver.
We were such dorks.
So, you're in search of buried treasure, are ye? Well, if it's treasure ye seek,
mine eyes spot two fair pirate wenches.
Dad, get away! We're in the middle of an important project.
Oh, a project. Never mind then. I apologize.
I mean it!
All right. Supper's in five. Wash your hands, you grubby pirate kids.
So lame. As I was saying, if it's treasure you seek, you've come to the right place. But be forewarned, the journey will be treacherous and full of treachers.
Nice.
To find the treasure of Price Isle, you will need the map from the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard. Only the map can lead ye to the treasure ye seek. But be forewarned. Again, only those with pure hearts will be able to see what the amulet shows them.
The amulet.
Good luck. And... bye.
Dude. That was...
hilarious. We were so, so ridiculous.
We still are, Max. We still are. Okay. Forget everything. Today, we go treasure hunting. I think I know what 8-year-old you meant by the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard.
Our old sketchbook. This is where we kept all our pirate drawings.
Yep. Now let's see this map.
This looks like a page was ripped out. I wonder if it's the map.
Hey, check this out. This page was ripped out. Do you think it's the map?
If it is, there's no way I would have thrown it out. Maybe it's mixed in with the rest of the drawings?
So much for telling Chloe now. All she cares about is finding this map. But where could it be? Chloe and I were doing a lot of drawing in Miss Shelley's class. I wonder if the map is mixed in with her school supplies from that year. This looks like a page was ripped out. I wonder if it's the map. People say a lot of things about the Prescott family, but this is pretty cool. I remember writing this. It's a story where you choose what happens. Wonder if I could still get to the end.
Oh, yes! Take that, Rat King. Don't move. This angle is perfect.
Why be shy? Get in here, dude. Subject and photographer. You really do it all, Max.
I try. I think this was the first class Chloe and I had together. Not sure I learned much about the Stars and Stripes. Bingo. I'm remembering this now. Didn't we make some crazy puzzle? You need the telescope and the amulet.
Which we hid inside a dark cavern, aka the attic!
Ugh, why did we do that to ourselves?
Because we were 8 years old and the attic was the scariest place we could think of.
You think it's still there?
Should be. As long as the clean police haven't gotten to it first.
Okay, and once we have the amulet and the telescope, we use them to reveal the treasure. Somehow.
Here's what's happening. I'll head to the garage to dig up my old telescope. You go find that amulet. We'll meet out back at the pirate ship.
You mean the swings?
Yes, the pirate ship. Captain Bluebeard and Long Max Silver right again, bitches!
I'll find a way to tell Chloe later. If this has to be my last day here, might as well have one final pirate adventure. Okay, Chloe said she hid the amulet in the attic. The only way in is through the broom closet. I can't believe I won't be able to call Arcadia Bay home much longer. I slipped and broke this post a few years ago, but Chloe insisted on taking all the blame. Even after she got grounded, she never squealed. What a friend. I don't think I've ever actually seen anyone reading these books. The Two Whales makes the best Belgian waffles. No other diner could even come close. It's so sweet that Chloe's mom takes this photo with her to work. I always like to imagine I could open that wardrobe and step into another world. I don't think I could ever handle a real-life murder investigation. Chloe's mom is trying to quit smoking. Aw, Chloe's parents are so cute. The principal at Blackwell wants to meet with Chloe's parents. I wonder what about. get into a fight? She never gets in trouble. I'm glad her dad stood up for her. A voicemail? I wonder if it's still there. Sometimes I really wish I had siblings. Chloe hasn't mentioned a trip. Maybe it's supposed to be a surprise. Oh, so cool. Chloe is such a nature nerd. I bet she's gonna love it. Most strikes? How can that be so cool and so dorky at the same time? Awesome that Chloe's mom wants to teach kids. She'd be really good at it. Makeup is great for acting in Halloween costumes. Any other time, I just don't get it. Chloe's mom bought me a toothbrush because I spend the night here so often. Well, I used to. The things inside this cabinet haven't changed very much over the years. I guess Chloe never really grew out of wanting to be a pirate. The entrance to the dark cavern is in there. Bluebeard's chosen hiding place for the mysterious amulet. There it is, the dark cavern. Crap. I can't get into the attic if I can't even reach the door. I need to find something to stand on. I'm sure I can find something around here to boost me up. Maybe this will make me tall enough to reach. It's a start. I gotta find something I can stack on top of it. It seems like Chloe's dad always has a project around the house. There. I just need a few more inches. Not bad for an improvised stepladder, but it's still not tall enough. Chloe's room has always been home base. It's hard to think this. I've gotta find that amulet before I meet Chloe out back. I think that should be tall enough. There is a ton of stuff up here. How will I ever... There it is. Of course Chloe hid the amulet in the hardest place to get to. I remember it took this thing like 100 years to rewind the land before time. I think I can squeeze through now. Not a single country record. These must belong to Chloe's mom. I remember this. Chloe refused to get another goldfish after she had to flush Calico Jack. That's full of decorations Chloe made when she was 5. She thinks they're embarrassing, but I think they're cute. It's a good thing I'm big and burly. Otherwise, moving this furniture would be kind of difficult. Keep it moving, desk. Crap. You have to go back. I need to move that cooler, but this desk is in the way. I've got to get through, which means this desk has got to move. Closer. pretty heavy. Glad this thing is empty. Free to move about the attic. This looks like it used to be a nice desk. I guess everything ends up in an attic eventually. This is a nice close-up shot. A fitting reward for a journey full of treasures. Got you. This thing is cool, I guess. I wish I could remember how it works. Chloe Price, my best friend. It's so weird being back in this attic after so long. I remember being terrified of this place. I think when you're a kid, you're only afraid of things that can hurt you. But when you get older, you become more afraid of hurting the people you care about. And spiders.
Ha ha! I have you now, Skellywag.
Man, I'm gonna miss her.
Watching me up there, Creeper?
You are one of a kind, Chloe Price.
What?
I'm lucky you're my best friend, that's all.
Damn right you are, you mushy weirdo. Did you find the amulet? Awesome. Now get your ass down here, we have treasure to find.
On my way.
Dude, you did it!
No big deal.
Bring the amulet over here so I can see.
Chloe is so excited. I better bring her the amulet before she makes me walk the plank. Chloe's bottle rocket. The fastest way to get an entire bottle of soda in your hair.
Yo-ho, yo-ho, a pirate's rum for me.
Do you drink this?
Yar!
No, not really. I had to fish an empty bottle from the recycling bin.
That's probably for the best.
Some pirate you are.
Hey, Chloe.
Yar.
Mind ho!
Perfect. I wish I could freeze this moment and never have to leave it. Glider swings. The best way to simulate a storm on the high seas. This thing looks so much smaller than I remember. I can't believe Chloe still has it. Actually, after this morning, I can. I never understood why it's called a Jolly Roger. How jolly can you be if you're dead?
Wait just a minute. Yarr! You must ask permission before setting foot, or peg, on another captain's boat.
Permission to come aboard, Captain Bluebeard?
Granted.
One amulet, coming right up.
Okay, I think it goes... Damn it. I forget how to make this stay on.
Stay here. I'll find something to hold it on.
Thanks, Max.
Time to stick the amulet to the telescope. Then that treasure is ours. I'll miss Chloe more than the rest of Arcadia Bay combined. It's not even close. If you told me this morning that we'd be spending the day as pirates, I would have thought you were crazy.
Yeah, I probably look like a loser, huh?
Chloe, you could never be a loser. Even if you tried.
Well, yeah. But best friend code requires you say that. It's just... this whole day has made me feel like a little kid again.
I can't believe we were 8 and 9 when we planned this.
I can. This tiny kid's head is squeezing the shit out of my head.
Well, treasures don't find themselves.
Lead the way.
I've spent so much of my life here. Every little corner is familiar. Comforting. These games we're playing. Buried pirate treasure from our past selves. Is this all selfish of me? Why is this making me feel more guilty about leaving? How am I going to...
What's up, dude?
Bro.
Don't you mean sis?
Actually, I meant dweeb.
Dork.
Doofus.
Only doofuses say doofus. You know what, Max Caulfield?
What, Chloe Price?
You're the frickin' best. That's all.
Talk about mushy. Where'd that come from?
I was just thinking about how awesome this day is. And how awesome we are. Okay, enough of this shit. There's treasure to be unburying.
I still wish I could live in the world we drew. Chloe and I have done lots of homework at this table. It's so weird we're at different schools now. I guess Chloe's mom comes all the way back here to smoke. Poor Bongo. Chloe took his death so hard. This was a fun experiment. I'm almost surprised we actually managed to grow something. I miss you, buddy. It's not that I don't like the blue. I'm just sad to see the old color go. Score! One step closer to getting that treasure. Whatever it is. All I'm saying is, I've never broken my wrist taking a picture. I'm really gonna miss Price family barbecues.
Avast, matey. Have you brought me prize?
Ahoy, Bluebeard. I have brought the stickiest tape in all the Seven Seas.
Well done, fellow scallywag.
Just like old times. Huh, Max? Remember how we used to talk about ruling the bays of Arcadia one day? We thought we were gonna be pirates forever.
If being a pirate means acting silly and going on crazy adventures together, then we'll always be pirates.
Hell yeah. Would you like to do the honors, Long Max Silver?
Me? Are you sure?
Of course. Come on, Navigator. Point me to some treasure.
Wait, how am I supposed to use this?
The drawing on the lens. It should line up with something?
Here goes nothing. Okay, this drawing is supposed to line up with something. I think the drawing should turn the real world into something piratey. I think I have the right angle, but where does it line up? Got it.
Yes! You rock! Where is it? Here?
Okay, take a step right. No, no, the other right.
My other right or your other right?
My other right.
Got it. Wait, what?
Just go that way. Perfect. Now come towards me. Bingo.
That is not what we buried.
What is this?
I don't know. Let's open it.
From Bloody Bill. Who's that?
I'll get the tape player.
Aha. Chloe's dad is such a goofball.
Ahoy there, plankwalkers. It's me, Bloody Bill, the Pirate King.
What?
By now, you'll have seen that I dug up your treasure, which would normally make us mortal enemies. But hear me out. I haven't pilfered a thing. On the contrary, I figured you swashbucklers might not be back to your loot for some time, so I've given it extra protection from the winds and rain. I'm sure you're excited to open your time capsule, so I won't go on too long. Just know that Bloody Bill is bloody proud of you. Both of you. Keep those sails trimmed and that anchor scrubbed. And always remember, the real treasure is...
friendship.
Love.
Your Oregon State prepaid college savings plan.
Ugh.
That's what we originally buried.
Huh, yeah. I guess it probably would have gotten ruined underground. Holy crap! It's Billy the Squid! He's alive! Oh, man!
It really is like a time capsule.
No way!
Chloe, look at this. We wrote each other letters.
Oh, I remember these. Chloe Price. Thanks, Max. I hope you are having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend. Aw, you are so cute. Check it out.
Ugh, Maxine.
How about mine? What did I write?
This is so Chloe.
You were really sweet.
Oh, man. I was really goopy.
I like it.
That's because you're a goop.
This is so cool. There's so much to look at.
Is your mom going to mind about this mess?
Dunno. I thought they'd be home by now.
Max, remember scratch art? Oh, I love this stuff.
I'm gonna draw something.
All these memories. I want to look at everything. This container looks like it could last 100 years.
Holy crap! It's the end of that comic in Chloe's room. Oh, this is gross.
These are awesome. Chloe's always been good at making up cool things to do. Our time. Most of these are pretty far off base. It's so hard to predict the future. Maybe it's better to enjoy the present instead. It's good to see you, old friend. It actually might be really fun to write letters to Chloe after I move. Is writing once a week too often? Will I run out of things to say?
Ugh, keep messing up my picture.
Their recording things was so much fun in third grade. You sure were troublesome to find. That's so cool that Chloe's mom is thinking about this. There. Now you've got something pretty to look at. I love how Polaroid cameras make every photo look a little nostalgic. Manga might be the one thing where Chloe out-nerds me. We always make so much more of a mess here than at my house. Much better.
Somebody's a goody two-shoes.
I always look especially short next to Chloe. That was a good week. I used every possible excuse to be here for breakfast. Chloe's grandparents live in Idaho now. I guess, compared to that, Seattle's not so far. I wonder if that's the voicemail Chloe's mom was talking about. She did say she didn't want Chloe to hear it, but if Chloe's in trouble at Blackwell, this might be my only chance to get her to talk about it. Looks like Chloe's a lot more responsible than I am with my allowance. I wonder if I could recreate this photo with Chloe now. Chloe and I have been friends for so long. Maybe I'm worrying too much about this move changing things. I guess I should try talking to Chloe again about my... Hey! What if my being in Seattle finally convinces Chloe to try an MMO?
Yes?
Pose for a photo with that? Okay. Tip your head back and put your arms out. And a really big smile.
Like this?
It's perfect. Stop moving. Really cute, Chloe.
You're not so bad yourself.
Chloe and I spilled that wine months ago, but I still feel bad about it. You're such a space hog. Move over.
Nope.
I wish this moment could last forever.
Hey, hippie.
How's the masterpiece?
Working on the last bit. How about you? Done with the time capsule?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, perfect, because now I'm finished. Check it out.
Oh, gosh. I really miss Bongo.
I saw you giving him a flower. It was so sweet.
Oh, Chloe, you were really drawing me that whole time.
Whoa. Mushiness alert. Keep it together, Max.
I guess now's my chance to tell Chloe I'm leaving. We might not be alone again once her parents get back.
Hey, ready for something else? I've got a great plan for the afternoon.
Crap. I don't want to ruin the rest of the day.
You're staying for dinner, right?
Would Chloe even want me to tell her? She didn't seem to want to talk about anything serious upstairs.
Max?
It's just Seattle. I'm probably overstressing about the whole thing. Right? Chloe?
Max?
I want to tell you something.
Okay.
My family's moving to Seattle. Really soon. Hey.
In 3 days, right?
What? You knew that?
Our parents do talk, you know?
But they said I should be the one to tell you.
They still told my parents. I guess Mom and Dad were trying to keep quiet too, but they're bad at hiding anything. Don't look so worried, Max. It's okay. Come on, Dorkmeister. It's not the end of the world.
I should have just told you earlier. God, I feel so stupid.
Max, I said it was okay.
I was trying to tell you this morning, but...
But I totally distracted you with the pirate tape. Success.
Seriously?
I didn't want this hanging over us all day. Plus, I know you hate this kind of conversation, so... I just left it alone, you know? Come on. I want to spend every minute we have together... having fun.
We'll keep in touch, okay? And visit, and maybe we'll move back. Who knows?
Chill out. We can go to college together. It's gonna be fine. We're Max and Chloe, remember? We're always together. Even when we're not.
That's true.
Cool. Let's find something fun to do. Mom?
Black flies on the windowsill. That we are, that we are, that we are to know. Winter stole summer's thrill, and the river's cracked and cold. See, the sky is no man's land, a dark and plumed estate. Hope here needs a humble hand, not a fox found in your place. That we are, that we are, that we are to hold. comfort came against my will. And every story must grow old. Still I'd be a traveler. A gypsy's reins to face, but the road is weary. With that fool found in your place. No man is an island, for this I know. But can't you see, or maybe you were the ocean when I was just a stone. So here we are.
To be there with you now. It's so hard trying to say what I'm thinking. If I could just see you. But we'll get good at it, great at it. We'll write and talk all the time, and then you'll come visit, and it'll be like I never left. I mean it. You don't have to worry about anything changing. Dealing with so much other stuff. You don't deserve any of this. Chloe, listen. Even if we're moving for good, we are always together, okay? Even when we're apart, we're still Max and Chloe. I will always love you.